Welcome back. In this section, I will talk about object-oriented features of Scala. If you had an opportunity to learn C++ or Java or maybe any other object-oriented language, you are good to start this section. I am assuming that you are already familiar with object-oriented concepts, and in this section, we will discuss Scala implementation of those concepts. In the next set of videos, we will cover following topics. Before we start learning object-oriented Scala, let me introduce you to the Scala's concise coding style. We'll start with a simple example. Let us create a class. Here is the specification. Pause the video and write it in Java or C++. You will write code that looks something like this. It's Java's style class definition, but I wrote it in Scala. In Java style, you will have some private properties and a public constructor. You will also have a getter and a setter for your private properties. When you want to instantiate this class, you will write code like this. When you want to read the private field, you will call a getter method. When you want to modify the private field, you will call a setter method. These are the basic things in Java programming. Everyone knows it. You might be wondering why I am telling all this. Is there anything wrong with this code or style? Nothing. Everything is good. Scala as a language supports that style, but that is not Scala's style. Let's see how we can do the same thing in Scala. Here is the class definition. This one-liner replaces all of the code that we wrote earlier. You can instantiate the class as you do it in Java. But when you want to read the member variables, instead of calling a getter method, you will use them directly. There is no need to call a getId and a getName method. In fact, you don't need the set methods as well. You can directly modify the members. Wait a minute. If you are a Java programmer, you will be getting confused. A Java programmer will stop me there and argue that this whole thing is not a big deal. We can do it in Java as well. I mean, the single line class definition is impressive. But these members, they appear to be a public field. If we declare our members using a public modifier, we can achieve the same thing in Java. But in object-oriented languages, we don't prefer using public fields. We prefer using a private field and a getSet method. Do you agree with this argument? If yes, let me ask you a question. What is wrong with the public field? Why do you want to use get and a set method pair? Pause the video and think about it. In fact, that's an easy question. When we use a method, we can add logic to validate the data. Let me show you a Java style example. We defined a class for a circle. We want to make sure that no one should be able to set the radius of a circle to a negative number. We make the radius private and implement a setRadius method. Now, you can add the logic to validate the radius, right? That's the main reasoning behind making our members private and implementing a getSet method pair. That's a good reason. But you must agree that using a public field is more convenient compared to using a method call. Look at these two simple examples. You are typing less. Your code is easy to read. It looks more like a mathematical expression. And you are also following the functional programming principle. I mean, the functions and the values should work in the same way, right? When you use c.radius, you are using it as a value without knowing whether it is a value or a function. In fact, to your surprise, the radius in this example is internally a function. I'll explain that in a minute. But since the radius is internally a function, we are not losing the ability to add some logic. I can still add logic to validate the data. Here is the code for Scala circle. Don't worry if you don't understand the code. I'll explain everything. Let's see how to use it. Got an exception because I tried to initialize it with a negative value. And this one worked. When you don't need to implement the validation, you can use a concise code, a single liner class definition. We did use that syntax for the customer class, right? When you need to add a validation, you can modify your code and put validation in place. And the most important point is this. Adding a validation is not going to impact the rest of the code. You can still use the members as a public field. If you didn't get it very well, don't worry. I'll come back to this example again in the next video. But the point that I wanted to make is very simple and straightforward. When you are learning Scala's object-oriented features and syntaxes, learn it with an open mind. When you are coding in Scala, bring your mind out of the Java's style and use Scala's approach. You'll find it sweet and short. Great! In the next video, I'll formally start object-oriented Scala and talk about Scala classes. Thank you for watching Learning Journal. Keep learning and keep growing.